Stepping out in faith. Stepping out in faith does not mean you are blindly stepping out in faith into the unknown. Rather, stepping out in faith means you are consciously and confidently choosing to step out in faith because of the trust you have in God. Stepping out in faith can be hard. Many people believe stepping out in faith means you are stepping out in blind faith. This is not true at all, as a person does not mindlessly step out in faith when they place faith in Jesus. In order for people to step out in faith, a person first ensures what they are stepping out on is sturdy and true. The importance of faith. Each day, you probably sit down in a chair. Whether consciously or unconsciously aware, you have firm faith and trust that the chair will support you when you sit down. If you did not have firm faith and trust in the chair, you probably would not sit down. Likewise, when a person places faith in Jesus, they are not mindlessly stepping out in blind faith. When an individual places faith in Jesus, they fully believe Jesus is who he says he is and that he conquered the grave. The disciples of Christ and the early followers of Jesus did not mindlessly or blindly step out in faith. They believed in Jesus to the point of death. Each of the disciples of Jesus except for the Apostle John died for their faith in Christ. Many early Christians also became martyrs for their faith in Jesus. Nobody would willingly die for something they knew was false. The disciples and the early followers were willing to die for the cause of Christ because they knew with their entire being that he was God and that he rose from the dead.
I don't know who this is for, but God is waiting on you to take action and step out in faith, because 2 Kings 5:11, Naaman actually thought God was going to bring his miracle to him. But to get his breakthrough, Naaman had to step out in faith. So, you know, sometimes we have to meet God halfway through our action.
People are so afraid of failure, but failing at something and being a failure is two different things. You are never a failure as long as you refuse to quit. And so, you're never going to succeed at anything if you're so afraid of failure that you won't try. So I tell people, step out and find out. And then faith steps out. It steps out into the unknown. You know, think about when Joshua was told to cross the Jordan and he had to put his foot in the water before the water parted.
You know what the Psalm says?
¿Sabes qué dice Salmos?
And I'm going to leave you with this.
Y te voy a dejar con esto.
It says, taste and see.
Probad y ver
that the Lord is good.
Que Dios es bueno.
Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him.
Dichoso el hombre que en él confía.
So you want to see your miracle?
¿Quieres ver tu milagro?
Take a step of faith.
Toma ese paso de fe.
He didn't say he was going to give you the roadmap.
Él no dijo que te iba a dar el mapa.
But he says, taste and see.
Pero te dijo, prueba y ve.
That I am good.
Que yo soy bueno.
Taste and see.
Prueba y ve.
That I am enough for your journey.
Que yo soy suficiente para tu jornada.
Taste and see.
Prueba y ve.
That I will do miracles, signs and wonders before
que voy
you.
A hacer milagros y señales delante
that
de
I
mí.
Will be your provider in the desert.
Que voy a ser tu proveedor en el desierto.
That I will be your healer when someone hurts you.
Que voy a ser tu sanador cuando alguien te hiere.
That I will be peace in the midst of adversity.
Que voy a ser la paz en medio de la adversidad.
So he doesn't promise a lot of things.
No te promete muchas cosas.
But he says, taste and see.
Pero te dice, prueba y ve.
Anybody that takes refuge in the Lord,
cualquier persona que toma refugio en Dios,
will not be left alone.
No va a estar solo.
Because Peter could have very easily stepped out of the boat and said, y'all, come on. No, he could have used their relational equity. Y'all know we've seen Jesus do stuff like this before. Don't miss out on this opportunity. No, I know your marriage is at the brink, but I've seen God restore marriages before. I know your children are out there, but I've seen God do it before. Come. And because there were scared saints in the deep, they missed the miracle. What miracle will you miss because you stay on the boat? He says, yes, come. So Peter went over the side of the boat and walked on the water towards Jesus. Can we stop and give Peter a hand clap? No, y'all, Peter.
Do something with the word he spoke. Stop waiting for God to do all the work. Stop waiting for God to align everything perfectly before you take a chance. If it wasn't risky, it wouldn't require faith, but if it didn't require faith, it wouldn't please God. If where you're going doesn't require faith, you're not headed toward the will of God. If where you are doesn't require faith, you're not standing in the will of God. The will of God will always require faith, and faith means there's risk. But risk is there that we might grow our faith. When God speaks, we step out on that promise, fully believing that God is able. And in doing so, we receive the promise.
This video is for everyone that's stepping out in faith and the people around you don't understand it. We're in the middle of the holidays, which means you're going to be getting a lot of questions like, what are you doing these days? I heard you left your job. Did I hear you're starting a new business? And unfortunately, a lot of this comes with negativity and a condescending tone. And it's really scary and can be hurtful because usually it comes from our closest friends and family that we thought would support us the most. My encouragement to you is that God didn't speak to them, He spoke to you. And that if you have a word from God, He is on your side. And if God is for you, who can be against you? I know you want the affirmation of your friends and family, and you'll probably get that one day. But right now, you need to lean into the affirmation and the approval that you have from God. You are approved by God. He has given you a destiny. He has given you a purpose, and you don't need the approval of man if you have the approval of God. So this holiday season and any time in the future when you feel that negativity from people, remember they didn't call you, God called you. So lean into the affirmation and the approval that you can only get from your Heavenly Father. Comment approved by God if you believe this and share it with a friend.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work... He starts a good work. He's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and He will surely see it through to the end. He says He makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if He finds you, He is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to Him, you will not be able to know Him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if He found you and He's brought you this far, then He's faithful enough, He's able enough, and He's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because He does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No. The Lord finishes His work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you even says, before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you, I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you, there's a plan for you, there's a purpose for you, there's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peck. So when you look at a peck, Mr. Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peck cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakala zizohole. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, sisli rat. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says, come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are the focus view, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching it.